for years. This is not something that just happened. This is things that we've been doing for years. It's been going on and on and on. Hold on with the drums for a second, sir. People's Organization for Progress has been doing this kind of work for years, brother. Can you hold up with the drum for a second? We're trying to hit a message, sir. We need to make sure that Prudential understands this, that they haven't paid taxes in this city for over 30 years, and that the people in this community have been suffering. One of the chants we've been saying is that the banks got bailed out. The banks got $800 billion, and in turn, they gave their people raises. In turn, they didn't give loans to individuals. The banks are actually sitting on $2 trillion of cash right now. They can stop the recession tomorrow, but refuse to do it because they would rather be rich at the expense of us. When people yell, we are part of the 99%, that's just not a number. 99% means that you are part of the overwhelming majority of working people in this community.
Disobedience, and we need to do it as much as we possibly can,
right,
to let these people know that we
are sick and tired of being sick and tired. That we are sick and tired of being sick and tired. And we're not going to sit around and watch these people get away scot-free while our brothers and sisters are murdered in the street and our mothers and fathers are losing their jobs because these people refuse to pay taxes and they want to live filthy rich. Some of these corporations don't pay the country taxes, not just your city. They don't pay the United States taxes at all. They here for free. If you don't pay your property tax, they come in to lock you up. They're going to shut your put a board on your house. They're going to send a constable to put you out on the street. But these people refuse to pay taxes. And not only that, they got politicians in office that's still trying to give them tax breaks on top of the damn breaks they got already. We got a governor that's saying that people that make over $400,000 should have a tax break. People that make millions of dollars should have a tax break. Meanwhile, they got the police out here on you when they firing the police at the same time. These people don't want the police either. They don't like police. They don't want the fire department. They don't want workers. They want their own private police. They want private police and private wars. They'd rather have the police protect their buildings and not you. The only time they protected you was when you were property. When we were property, then they protected us. In fact, they had a law called the Fugitive Slave Law where they came and got you because you were somebody else's property. But now you have fought so you don't be property. They're going to make sure they don't protect you or protect anybody else on the street. That's why our children are dead in the street. Our children die in the street. 70 and 80 children die a year. 120 and 130, some cities 200, 300 black men die every single year. On these streets, they dying and being murdered, and nobody is doing anything about it. You know what they say? We don't have the money.
That's a lie.
We don't have the money. Oh, they got the money. The money is in there. That's where the money is. The money is in there. And as soon as we organize ourselves and demand that we get it, is when we'll get it. One day we're going to have to go to Port Authority. One day we're going to have to go to Port Authority. One day we're going to have to go to Port Authority. We're going to have to go to the airport and the seaport. We're going to have to lay down and say nothing moves until we eat. One day we're going to say nobody works until we work. We're going to ask for a general strike one day. We want to see how organized we are. Nobody works. No teachers, no cops, no firemen, no construction, no building cleaning, no maintenance workers. Nobody works. Everybody stay home until these people do their fair share. We need to get so organized that we refuse to pay these banks our mortgage. When 75,000 people refuse to pay Bank of America that month? What happens when 100,000 workers refuse to pay Bank of America that month? Yeah, they all go into foreclosure. And I want to close on this. If the banks is too big to fail, how come the people aren't big enough to fail? If the banks are too big to fail, then the schools are too big to fail. If the banks are too big to fail, then the hospitals are too big to fail. If the banks are too big to fail, then our jobs are too big to fail. And that's what we need. I support people in this organization for progress. Keep pushing, keep organizing. All power to the people.